Welcome back to Let's Play Mega Man X Command Mission. A little thing to note, I'm now level 8. That increased my, my immunity was 11, now it's 13, or was it 12? I don't think it matters too much. Anyway, let's continue on. I just went around in circles until I got in like two fights just to get the thing. Anyways, back up in tank energy 100%, which I could have just healed and got that anyway, but no, well.
You canceled the self-destruct? You meddling Maverick Hunter!
Jango, what you're doing is wrong! I'm gonna take you down!
You gotta be kidding! You're a fool if you think a single Maverick Hunter has the power to take me on. So you used this to sneak into the building.
Spider!
Jango! Keep your hands off that! Creeps like you have no business touching it! Back off, if you know what's good for you.
You don't know when to give up, do you? Fine. I'll make short work of you both!
Anyway, this is Jango. I actually bought that second Thunder Resist to give the spider, but I've completely forgot that, sadly, you can't actually equip him with it. Thing to note, Spider comes with a item equipped. I think it's called Bluff. Makes one enemy attack miss. Yeah, just used it. Sadly. Failed to steal item. He comes with that. Unfortunate for him, he is thunder-based, and I have lots of fire stuff on the X. So this isn't going to be too bad. He has 9,000 life, and Lightning Rod is what makes him actually quite difficult. The plus 10% speed kind of stinks. Spider's action trigger is basically playing poker. That's what it is. But not really too worried about that at the moment. Considering I've already lopped off about 10% of his HP. This is his big nasty attack. Yeah. It's really not that bad. Thunder Guard! Woo! Don't need it, really. Continuing on. I'm pretty much saving X's. Whatchaman calls it? WE. Let's play a little poker, shall we? I got a pair. Yeah, I got a pair. It's actually probably better off if you're regular attack. The higher is WE, the better the hands tend to be. But that's not always the case. Yeah, he's getting a fully charged charge collider in the next turn. Again, he has 9,000 life. Spider's main job here is to actually do this. And I also have Ultra Fire and Mega Fires that I could use on him, which I've been completely ignoring for some reason. Anywho, let's get this done. I don't think Charge Collider actually does fire damage, does it? Nah, it doesn't really matter. Needless to say, he's going to take one hell of a beating with this either way. Yeah, that's quite significant. Yeah, that's really going to start to stink, isn't it? Anyway, item! Where is it? 1,000 power! Which does 1,500. Don't use that on your way up here. Trust me. Don't. Ugh. This Spider probably actually kill him just doing that stuff.
Ready?
Meh, that's not too threatening. No. That's another 10%. Jango is not that hard. He can give you trouble if you don't know how to basically take advantage of him and do terrible things to him. And that was really short. Holy crap. I expected that to take longer. Anyways, I get 30% extra EXP. I used Mega Fire to beat him up. And I didn't even show his hyper mode, did I? Crap. His hyper mode actually gives him a speed penalty, but makes him immune to everything. Even healing just makes him immune. It only lasts like 2 turns, I think. Anyway, Thunderbuster, which is going to be important, and a full sub tank, which is quite nice of him to give that up.
Thanks, Spider. You really helped me out.
X, you defeated Jango, didn't you?
Chief R. Yes, I did, but without Spider, I would have been in trouble.
I see. Spider, I give you my thanks. You fought for our comrade, Ale.
Ale was my partner back when I started bounty hunting. I goofed. He got wasted for it.
I see. Quite a lucky coincidence that you were here.
A coincidence? I bet Ale was the one who brought us together.
How fitting.
And Spider has joined the party, and that dialogue was kind of terrible. Chapter 2 is done. I don't know if I actually want to show the beginning stuff of third chapter 3, because I kind of would like to keep it separate, but the 7-minute part, no. Well, 8-minute-ish.
We somehow managed to regain the base.
The base, huh? That's great. But what good does a base do us when there's just 3 of us?
You're quite right, but I have an idea. 30 miles northwest, there's an old force metal mine on Tiana Island. Reploids at the mine who resisted the rebellion army are still trapped inside. It's essentially a POW camp.
So if we bust the Reploids out, they might join us?
Yes, and there's one girl we really need. The system operator, Nana. If we could rescue her, she could restore functionality at our base.
Yeah, so we need to get Nana because this place is extremely useless to us. Hello. How convenient that it was set to Tiana Camp. But what we're actually going to do is go shopping since, well, I've got money. Not much, but I do have money. Anyway, Jack of Diamonds, 75% WE or more, Final Blow boosts any. That's pretty much what most of his stuff does when it's above 75% weapon energy. It usually does something snazzy, but I really don't care for that one. So we're gonna go shopping. Hello. Yay. And this will actually bring us to the shopping center once it actually gets going. I don't know who the pilot of that is, but They pretty much drive that thing perfectly, don't they? He's a little bit odd for a robot man. I didn't even read that. I'm sorry. You know what? Being a Reploid herself and keeps her hands off the machinery, that sounds like some sort of robot innuendo. Some guy who's really strong named Massimo. Anyway, figure tokens. Shadow's Trail, we get a bat bone. Yeah, you need 2 tokens for each one of those, but it's really not important until after Chapter 3, so, yeah. Weapon Shop, what I want to buy is that. That is extremely nice. The whole blanket attack, it hits everything on the field. It's quite nice. This one's really good for boss battles, but I really want that one first. Thunder Missile, Tomahawk, that, and that. Yeah. So I'm going to get that. Let's see. Wait a second, what? I don't understand why it's not letting me trade in. Maybe it's initial equipment I can't sell or something. Which is kind of not happy. But yes, now once he gets 75% WE or more, he can hit everything on the screen, which is quite useful. Hello! I don't think I actually need anything from you. Not that I can afford it anyway. Ah, distractions. Anyway, this guy right here, General Marston, doesn't have any of the new stuff, but he carries everything. Yeah, pretty much right now everything's the same. You can actually buy anything that you really want at this point in the game from him. But later on that will not be so. This lady will actually allow you to teleport to places you've already been that is not part of the current chapter where you have to go to continue the story. That's what she's there for. And this lady, I believe, is the Force Metal Shop. Which, I really can't afford anything. This is actually pretty good. And I think I'm gonna buy a couple. That, and I don't think Spider has been equipped. Yeah, he has Bluff. That's it. Woo! Yep. You know, one of these times I will learn what buttons do what. Yeah, he starts with an action trigger, so that's at least 50%. And he gains 75%, so he'll be doing blanket attacks right off the bat. Haha! Oh, I love myself right now. That's what it means when it's green, I believe. If it's not, I'll cry. But, I think that's pretty much all I can do. Yeah, you can look at him here, I guess. That's nice. I actually didn't know you could look at him in the menu. But, this is actually a place later that you can, view them much easier. Yeah, let's go back and save, since I'm not actually going to start this chapter, since I'm in some sort of midway at the moment. All I gotta do is talk to R, and he'll transport me away, and I gotta stop dashing, because that noise is annoying. And when I start editing, I'm like, why am I dashing so much? Bad enough I have, like, 3 parts to edit anyway, and that this isn't going to be up for months. Also, some movies can be skipped instantly. Normal movies can also be skipped, but you have to press like the start button and hold it, or the X button and hold it. I have no idea what they are on the GameCube. I don't own a GameCube, so I have no idea what buttons skip it, but, you know, it doesn't really matter. Anyway, that's the end of Chapter 2, and some shopping in between chapters. I'm going to save right here, and next time, we will start Chapter 3 properly. Yes.